Street advertising is prohibited on walkways in Abuja. But one man has braced the odds to embark on a form of advertising that many have dubbed controversial. Emmanuel Okpareke runs a free specialized matchmaking agency for HIV-positive singles. And to seek more publicity, he has been uniquely advertising on walkways in major bus stops around Abuja City.
I advertise in the gutters. So sometimes I clean the gutters for them to place my advert. Do you understand? I clean the gutters to place my advert. And it takes a matured mind to look into that and see, what does this person who wrote here mean? When they arrest me, I say, see you, I never get money. Government has not come to my assistance. But these people, these are our young ladies and our young men. What do you want them to do? They really need to settle down. So we have to start somewhere.
Abuja residents who have come across such adverts proposing marriage between two HIV-positive individuals have had mixed reactions. Many wonder why a confidential health issue like HIV should form the basis for a marital proposal.
But it's a good idea because it will stop the spreading of disease, you know, spreading of the HIV is around. Because definitely some people, maybe HIV patient may want to have fun and you don't have someone to have fun with. So definitely go out and spread out there. So when they get married, definitely to reduce the rate of you know, a spread of HIV/AIDS to innocent people around the street.
I don't know their reasons, but whatever it is, it's not a good idea for somebody to bring two HIV men and female to put them together as husband and wife.
Now this person has it. What can we do to help him out of that mentality? You know, living in that mentality keeps faster than the HIV itself. But when we can socialize with this person, when we can bring him in and say he's a human being like us, that is what we are encouraging, not encouraging the spread again.
Okpareke denies exploiting his clients. The matchmaker says his strategy of grabbing attention through workplace advertising has put smiles on the faces of many lonely HIV-positive singles. He reads out requests by members of the public who have enrolled into his matchmaking agency on conditions of confidentiality.
She's a public servant. She's from Abia. She just needs a friend. She don't need anybody to disturb her life. She just needs a friend, somebody she can confide in. So let's see what she wrote. I need a partner who is God-fearing, everybody like God-fearing. Have a job, civil servant, public servant or businessman. Good looking. He's SSCE, he's a driver. Okay, he needs, first, she should be a Christian. Second, must be hard-working person. Must have a good character. He also said must be God-fearing. And she must have a big hip.
With many HIV-positive Nigerians struggling to face the reality of their new health status, also comes the fear that the matchmaker may be exploiting citizens.
For me, they're supposed to stop them. HIV and AIDS don't have a cure, except by tomorrow, which I don't know. But the what we can see now, there's no care for it, and there's no need for you to bring two people together because of that.
No, I don't look at it as an explosion of money. I think it's a means of advertisement that creates information and awareness to people. So I think it's the best thing to do.
With this advert now, some of them is a secret thing that will secretly call somebody and say, see, I'm this thing. And they are not bold enough to come to the open. So they'll secretly tell those people. That thing is a kind of a good idea.
But the matchmaker says he has sought registration with the government and notified them, with little response from the authorities. And after failed recognition efforts, he continues his business of specialized matchmaking using street advertising.
This matchmaking advert specifically targeting HIV-positive persons are spread around major bus stops, entertainment centers, hotels, and streets frequented by Abuja residents.
The National Agency for the Control of AIDS, NACA, is charged with regulating HIV/AIDS activities in Nigeria. And an official says the matchmaker may not necessarily be engaging in an illegal activity.
As NACA is the coordinating agency at the national level, at the state and including FCT plus FCT, you have regulatory authorities that support people that are doing the HIV work. And for the state, I expect that FCT is aware before they start putting their billboards for people to come out to in full knowledge to want to marry themselves and agree to a relationship is positive. There's nothing wrong with it. The only situation it will be wrong is if they are not aware of their status.
NACA is also encouraging match-made HIV-infected couples, especially women, to access health care that will lead to HIV-negative children.
One of the biggest challenges that we have, we want to get women to go to antenatal care so we can test them. And if they are positive, we can intervene to ensure they don't transmit HIV to their children, part of the zero new infections.
With a subtle public endorsement of a specialized matchmaking for HIV singles, Okpareke has continued to advertise around street corners. He has even opened a website.
I matchmake too on the net for now, and I have up to 30 applications there.
Statistics say 3.4 million Nigerians live with HIV/AIDS, and new infections continue to be recorded annually. With the new infections also comes stigmatization, which makes HIV-positive persons to feel unwanted, thereby making them to stay away from marriage for fear that no one will marry them.
So the little challenges they are facing is getting married. So I try my best to get into the system and look how these people manage their life. There are what they call support group in some of the government hospitals. But you can see in Nigeria, a lot of people don't have time for themselves. This support group, they come once in a while to interact with each other. But a lot of them complain, we don't have the time. So I say, okay, if you don't have the time, what do we do to help you and you still want to settle down? So I start looking on how best to make great time for them.
This is the gap that Okpareke says is out to fill so that HIV-infected persons can continue to live their normal lives. With limited funds to help these infected singles, the matchmaker says he has no other choice than to use his unique walkways advertorials. Sumner Sambo, TVC News, Abuja.